It echoed round the mountains like a salvo of guns. "Are you frightened?" he asked, squeezing the cold hand reassuringly. "Not very," she replied, with a breathless laugh. "But thunder is rather horrible, isn't it?"
"Yes, horrible," he agreed.
They moved on. They seemed to go a long way in the darkness. Presently, he said,
"Stand still now, until I find a light."
He let go of her hand and moved away. Linda stood still, scarcely breathing. She heard the scrape of a match, and saw him standing beside a rough wooden table, lighting a candle in an old-fashioned iron candlestick. The light showed up in his face, dark and intent. Linda saw that they were in a large circular chamber, part of one of the towers of the old castle. The walls were of bare grey stone. The floor was of large grey flagstones. There was a big open fireplace in the wall, with a fire laid ready for lighting, and before the fireplace was a roughly made wooden settle, very wide in the seat. The only other furniture in the chamber was a table and a cupboard. There were two small windows high up in the walls, barred with rusty iron bars. Ian looked at her and smiled. "Not much of a place to spend the night, I'm afraid," he said apologetically. "But it will look better when we get the fire going." He took a black bottle out of the cupboard and poured it over the sticks. "Paraffin," he explained. "The sticks get damp here, so I always keep a bottle of paraffin handy. There's a kettle here, too, so we can make something hot to drink. I hope you like cocoa."
She said, "I think you're a wizard."